can hear me? Hear me? Oh, yeah. Check, check. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Calvary Community Church, Fellowship of Deaf and Hearing Believers. I'm glad to see some of your faces. I haven't seen in a long time, so I see new faces. Welcome here. My name is Joey. I'm the pastor. If you don't recognize me, just shave my head because it was hot. I got tired of it. So I just like, it's just for once when it's hot. I was in Grand Terrence yesterday. Where was that? 109. I'm like, thank you, Lord. Good thing I... Cool. Tuesday night, what happens? Bible study, but this Tuesday, no Bible study. Just Tuesday. We have two minds clean. So we're going to tend everything up. So don't come in here, please. Because if I have to come in, I see your body, but he'll raise you again. Hey, Jesus did it. The disciples did it. It's possible. I believe that. After church, we can use some help if you're available. You need to move some things, prepare for the guys to come, to tend everything up. Because they're coming tomorrow. So after church, today, if you have time, we have to move the seats, the chairs, the tables, a few things. So after church, you're available. Offer 5 pizza so you can eat something. September 2nd, men, yay, men's fellowship, we're going to the shooting range. It's going to be a lot of fun. So, flyers, yeah. Just going to get the flyers. So, it's about $30 for entrance because we have a private range. And then the rest, we pay for ammo, we provide food, so you have to buy ammo. We'll have the guns ready, fight everything. It's going to be a lot of fun. We'll stay there for half of the day. So I encourage you, if you're going to the shooting range, practice your fingers. Pick your nose, pick your ears, whatever you do. Get some weights. Build some muscle and prepare yourself, because you will be sore. September 10th, at the Church Prep Fellowship, going to TNT, the Mexican restaurant right down the street. It's really good. Listen. Yeah, we'll give you the address when it gets closer. That's all announcements for today. Oh yeah, one more thing. Someone's birthday today. Whose birthday is it today? It's your birthday. Happy birthday to you. Stand up and say hi. No? Yeah. Stand up and say hi. Hi, hi. Birthday boy here. Happy birthday to you. For your birthday, you can get a free donut. It's free anyways. You get double. You get double donuts you want. How old are you today? 4? Wow, he's 4 years old. Awesome. Happy birthday to you. We don't do the punches here, 4 punches now. And on Facebook, I announced we're supporting the BID, the Bible Institute for the Deaf. This is the last week before we collect and we count and set. So I encourage you, you have your coins or your cash put in, or if you want, back there we have the iPad. You can swipe, put as much money you want, and put BID. So as soon as we get the welcome cards, we have welcome cards in front of you, filled out, tithing offering, so the ushers, come on up. I got all my seat covers, looked around the ground, looked in my bedroom, everything. Go ahead. This is for your tithe and offering. Back there we have the credit card machine too. Go ahead. Ooh, you clogged it up. Ooh, awesome. Go ahead. Put it in. a reminder, the Deaf Ministry Retreat is on October 20th and 22nd. And the deadline, well, really October 1st is to pay. September 30th, it increases after that. So make sure you fill it out. We have flyers back there. And we have campus registration. So if you need a ride over there, just let me know. And we'll have the van ready to ride over there. And we're going to stop at that delicious taco place, remember? Ooh, yeah. The taco truck was so good. Awesome. Okay. We're going to pray for the tithe and offering. Father of Heaven, Lord, we thank you for all you've done for us, the blessings you have given us, the finances you provide for us. We glorify you by giving back what you asked for us and more. As we give to BDID, Lord, we support missionaries over there in the Philippines. I see you touch them, bless them, overflow, pour your spirit there. Bless everyone who gave, those who are in need, provide for the finances. And those who couldn't come, who are sick, touch their bodies, heal their bodies, give them strength. Those who are struggling to come, Lord, open their hearts, fill the spirit with a hunger, and draw them here. They can't come here because of a ride, Lord. Speak to us and provide for a ride. Whatever is necessary to bring your people, as touch our hearts, we touch all those out there. Thank you, Jesus' name, pray. Amen. Next week, we'll start the run for funds. We support sending the kids to camp, summer camp. So, $1 bill, next week we start. I'll explain more about that next week. All right. Are you ready to worship the Lord? Ready to worship the Lord? Come on up, worship team. projector go down again. Yeah, that's all right. God is good all the time, right? Right now we're currently looking for a new projector. Yeah, trying to look for the right one in this kind of setting. Bright enough. Part two of the game ended last week. Are you smarter than an apostle? Last week we played a small game, a quiz, Bible quiz. Are you smarter than an apostle? I have a $5 gift card to Starbucks. $5 gift card to Starbucks. So do you think you're smarter than an apostle? I need two volunteers. How about you, Ben? Mabel? You? All right. There's five questions, so who answers the most with the $5 gift card? Let's start with you. Who walked out the tomb at the command of Jesus? Come and rise, come on out. You remember the name of the person? Starts with the L. Lazarus, give her 1 point. Nickname, Lazarus. Which Bible character saw angels on a ladder in heaven? Name of the person. Ethan? Watch it. Jacob, 2 points. The Pharaoh, the Pharaoh, what am I just saying? What country did he rule? Egypt? Egypt, 3 points for you. Moses? God fed what during the 40 years wilderness? The Jewish people. God feed what to them? What did yeah, Moses? Who got manna? Right, manna? Manna? Yeah, right, manna and. Point for you. Which prophet anointed Saul the king of Israel? Yes. Prophet Saul, the first king. You will become king. Samuel, you got 3 points, 1 point. Who has the most points? There you go. $5 Starbucks gift card. Good job. We'll be doing these once in a while, so practice studying your Bible. Awesome. All right, ready for the comics. Yep. Looks like the old Peaceful Spirit sermon. The automatic. machine. Sometimes we feel like we need that. Lord, what am I going to pray for today? If you're struggling with how to pray, ask the Spirit to pray for you. The Spirit can speak to you. Easy to know. Guide you. Hold up, guys. I think we're using the wrong plants. Noah. As we know, Noah built the ark. That's a joke. Wrong plants. Because he's building his own altar. We are continuing the ministry series. So right now we're on S. Remembered last week. Move, identify. Now, what was that? I am, right? I am. Yeah. Talk about we are all part of God's ministry. He uses each one of us. Everyone. God has to use for all of you. I'm worthless. He can use you. With God, He will use you. So as I said last week, I am. Who is I am? God. I gave you several examples who He is. I am the bread of life, the good shepherd, the living water, the way, the truth, and the life. We need to know who He is to serve Him better. That's why we need to know who He is. In ministry, we want to minister for Him, He's prepared. Don't go into it closely. Give yourself weapons. God has the armor. He's given us the armor. We need to put it on to fight the enemy. Satan is going to fight you. Are you going to fight him yourself? Good luck if you're going to try to fight him yourself. He's powerful, but not powerful than God. The Spirit wipes him out. But you need to have the Spirit. You need Him. You need to know who He is. And Satan talks. And he is the talker. Similar to Connor McGregor, you know, the boxing yesterday, he was all talk. Oh, I could be Mayweather, blah, blah, blah. He went. Unfortunately, he didn't. He lost in the 10th round by a technical knockout. So, Satan may talk. Oh, I could beat God. He said, God's already threw him out of heaven already. But he's still stubborn. Because he wants to fight against God. And he'll fight against you. But if you're going to fight the devil by yourself, you will lose. You need him to back you up. For the S, I have several. I want to focus on one today. Maybe next week I have another. The Spirit. I'm going to talk about the Spirit. I know in June, 2 months ago, I talked about the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is a person. It's a living thing. It lives with us. If we are in need, we call someone, right? If you fall and you can't get up, who are you going to call? Mama? Yeah, if your mama's there, you call your mama, yeah. But if you're alone, you can't get up, you call 911, right? You look for help. You go to your brother's for help, right? We have the Holy Spirit. If Satan is attacking us, okay, I'm going oh, I'm not going to give him a black eye. I'll be like, ah. Oh. Because I'm not strong enough. But with the Spirit, his words, boom, Satan's going down. Remember Mike Tyson? Mike Tyson, famous boxer. Huge black guy. Ooh. When he was young, he was one of the strongest boxers. Bow, boom, boom, boom. Holy Spirit's more than that. Yeah, put on the Holy Spirit's love. But one thing I noticed, we talk about the Father and the Son a lot. Do we talk about the Spirit? Sometimes it's forgotten. We forget about the Holy Spirit. The Spirit has many benefits for us. It does a lot for us. It was there since the beginning with Jesus and the Father. Always been there. When Jesus told him to baptize, what did he say? Baptize in the name of the Father and the Son. Am I missing something? And the Spirit, right? The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, together, they're a team. They need each other. They're like the baseball team, getting 9 people on the field for a good team to win, right? Unless you're with the Blue Jays, they stink right now or something. But they need 9. If you're missing right field, boom, boom, get the ball. If you're missing the pitcher, you can't play in the game without the pitcher, right? The catcher, you miss. You need every player on the field to play a game, right? You need all 3. We all battle the darkness every day. Tries to overcome it, but we have the light. If we live with the Spirit, we know the darkness. That can affect me. And you like talk to the hand. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 18 says that. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit. Do not get drunk, which leads to trouble, lots of trouble. We all know someone who's done that. Beautiful. But maybe you or one of them before. You know the effects of getting drunk. You already know that. It messes you up, makes mistakes. Sometimes, sadly, on the news we see drunk drivers. People get killed. Because they're not thinking. So we already know, at least to our minds, being forgetful. Make stupid mistakes. But say, be filled. Spirit. The Spirit fills your mind, protects you, and guides you, gives you a path. I told you we all are part of His ministry. But what is He calling us for? He called us all the different parts of His ministry. They're all equally important to Him. We have the tech team back there. We have the sound team. We have the children sitting there. The pastor. The announcement pastor. The usher. The different. Not only in the church. Outside too. Are you sharing the gospel? The good news with people out there? Homeless person comes, I'm hungry. What do you do? What does the Bible say? feed them if they're naked, clothe them if they're thirsty, give them something to drink if they're lacking in spirit, give the spirit, share the gospel of who Jesus is. You want power? The Holy Spirit. To be successful in his ministry, you must be filled with the Spirit. It's power. I'm always talking about Mario Brothers, you know the game? Super Mario Brothers. In the box. It's always like, we have the flower, we have the mushroom. You get bigger with a fireball. It's power, right? The Spirit is the same thing. It gives us power. Satan comes, the fireball. The Spirit is awesome. But you have to be willing to open and use it. When we accept Jesus Christ, the Spirit came into us. And we tell him, we can unlock. Come, I invite you to work in me. We have to be willing to let it work in you. That's the problem sometimes. People are willing. Sometimes I'm like, oh, well, oops, I messed up. But sometimes if I'm going the wrong way, hey, go this way. It guides me. It guides you. You have to be willing to listen. Listen, you know. You feel it. The tug. Tug on your spirit. Sometimes you're going somewhere and you feel your stomach like something doesn't feel right. That's the Spirit working in you. Don't do that. It guides you. But thank you. How important is the Spirit? Let's read Luke chapter 4, verse 1. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, left Jordan. He was led the Spirit into the wilderness. Now the Son of God, he received the Spirit. If the Son of God received the Spirit, it's very important, right? Yeah. He was the example. He needed the Spirit. As we know what happened in the wilderness, right? He fasted for 40 days and nights. Then Satan came up in the temple. He was full of the Spirit. Rejected him. And Satan ran away crying. He left. Because Jesus is full of the Spirit. Satan will come and test us. So I know the Spirit is important. So I need the Spirit to guide me, to fill me with wisdom. So I can fight against the darkness. Jesus depended on it, so we sure depend on it. Really, we must have it. So I don't want to fight alone. I need the Spirit to fight with me. The only way I can overcome. Spiritual warfare. How many of you are flesh? All of us. Yeah, that's too much flesh here, but ignore that. Yeah. Some of us have a little bit too much flesh, but the flesh sometimes tries to, we struggle with this sometimes. We get tempted. Tempting is not the sin itself, but doing the temptation against God. It's a constant battle because we're living sometimes I wish I could sleep in. Like, yeah, they'll be fine without me. They'll be fine. You show up. Where's Pastor Joey? Oh, I'm calling. I just obeyed my flesh today. I'm going to get a phone call from my boy, of course. Sometimes my flesh feels sick. Sick, weak, and tired. I stay home. Depend on the Spirit. There's been times when I was really sick. And I come, like, okay, I'm depending on you, Holy Spirit. And I stand up here, I don't feel sick at all. It's amazing. Preach His words. And finish off. Why? God's funny sometimes. But when I use Him, He helps me. He guides me. I'm going to read the four verses in Galatians. Verse 17, what the flesh, the body, desire, what contrary, opposite of the Spirit. And the Spirit is opposite of the flesh. So, it's a war. We've seen cartoons with the devil right here. Yeah. The angel. Hey, no. Yes, no. It's kind of like that. But you have the Spirit in you. But the closer you're with God, be silent. Go away. The closer you are with God, when you feel the Spirit, you know His voice. Like the first step, the sheep. We are His sheep. Bah, you know? The sheep out there, they know who the shepherd is. They call. Hey, come. The sheep are excited. And they come, right? But I go out there with strange sheep. I'm like, hey, come sheep. They're like, who's that guy? I don't know who that person is. Bad, no. That's what they're going to do. But when you know His voice, yes, Lord. You read the Bible. There's many prophets and people that hear His voice. They know. A conflict with each other all the time. It's a battle. Because we're in the flesh. But if you obey the flesh more than the Spirit, if you ignore the flesh, the Spirit, and grow, it's easy to resist. But you need the Spirit. Galatians chapter 5, verse 9 and 21. When you follow the desires of your sinful nature, the results are clear. Sexual immorality, impurity, lustful pleasures, idolatry, sorcery, hostility, quarreling, jealousy, outburst of anger, selfish ambition, dissension, and division. Envy, drunkenness, wild parties, and other simple things like this. I'm going to tell you again, as I have before, anyone living that kind of life will not inherit the kingdom of God. If you're living that kind of life, you will not inherit the kingdom of God. That's clear. But the Holy Spirit produces the kind of love, joy, improve your ministry. First thing, it gives you life. Second thing, it gives you love. Third, it gives you power. Fourth, it gives you faith. You need these things for your ministry. First thing, it gives you life. The Spirit that drew Christ. The Spirit that draws us to Christ is the Holy Spirit. The tug. Because in our hearts, we already have eternity. We know there is eternity. The Spirit taps us, come, come, come. Because it wants you to have life. Because before we had Jesus Christ in our heart, we were dead. Our spirits were dead. Our flesh is already dying the day you were born. I heard that quote, like, wow, imagine that. Your flesh is already dying the day you were born. Never thought of that. Because eventually in the future, my flesh will one day shut down. But the Spirit has eternity. But whatever we choose, our eternity is your choice. If God has the Spirit, hey, he's not annoying you. He wants you with him. We have the Word of God, and he has us to go and minister. But we must have life first before we share out there. No one's going to follow someone dead, right? You're not going to follow a zombie, right? Zombie. Are you going to follow a zombie? Like, no, I'm running away from those things. They eat my flesh. Eat my brains, yeah. Yeah. You're going to follow some alive, full of joy. And that's Jesus. Spirit, the one that gave us Jesus, with Jesus, guided him, protected him, and on the cross. The Spirit is the one that rose Jesus. It's the Spirit that rose Jesus. John chapter 3, verse 5 said, Jesus truly said, truly, truly I say to you, unless one born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Which is born the flesh is flesh. Which is born the Spirit is spirit. Nicodemus walked up to Jesus. How can I go into heaven? What must I do? You must be born again. What? Born again? Go back to my mom and be born again. That's what he was saying. Jesus was saying, you must be born again with the Spirit. It's the Spirit that raises you. And the Spirit that looks at you when you have Jesus Christ in your life and washes your sins away. We're all sinful. But we need Jesus Christ to wash our sins away. When it's time, the Spirit comes to raise us. You will see Jesus, the blood that washed our sins clean. Do you know Jesus? Yes, I know Jesus. I received him. And I believe in him. I have faith in him. Either way, we rise again, we're just going to fly. So get your cape's ready just in case. If you don't have a cape, make one. You hear the trumpet? I need to buy one of those compressed bags, you know. Get my cape in there and small. Carry it with me every day. Doesn't matter if you're death, you will hear that trumpet. You will know. And those who are in the Spirit will know that's His trumpet. We hear horns all the time, and that. So we'll hear that. We know it's not Him. But we will know His trumpet. We will know. John chapter 6, verse 63. It's the Spirit that gives my flesh is no help at all. The flesh of self does not help it. The Spirit that does that. Because of all the sins I did in my life, I can't wash them myself. I can't. I can pour bleach all I want, but it's not going to come off. Only the blood of Jesus can wash the sins away. So it's the Spirit that gives me life. The Spirit also gives you love. Second, for God has not given us the spirit of fear and timidity, but the power, love, and self-discipline. How many of you love someone here? We love each other, right? Brothers and sisters in Christ. I have my love for my wife, and my kids, and my Facebook. You know, we have love. I have love for my baseball team, my Angel. He has his love for his Boston. Cool. You have your love for your cats. Oh, five cats. Oh, I love our cats, yes. My daughter's like, yeah, I love my cats too. Who do you think buys their food? Of course I love them. But we have that love. He loved us before we loved Him. We were His enemies, and He loved us anyway. And He sent His Son on the cross because He loved you so much. And the Spirit is the one that gives us love. I have my love for my family, my church family. But what about the people out there? What about your enemy? Matthew chapter 5, verse 44. I tell you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. What? Really, Lord? Sometimes you feel that way. But remember Jesus on the cross. The people who put the thorns of crown on Him. The person who stabbed Him. Put the nail in Him. Those who pulled out His spear, made Him carry that heavy cross, the whipping Him. Have you seen the Passion of the Christ, right? You see the flesh being torn. Jesus still loved them. That tells us something. It's the Spirit that gives me a love for my enemies. I'd rather smack them in the head, that's for sure. The Spirit in me shows me that love. Love and well not that. The homeless people that come, we have to love for them too. The Spirit that helps us love, provide. The flesh, I try to tell you, I'm going to take care of yourself. Focus on yourself. Feed yourself. Clothe yourself. Ignore them. Spirit in me. I love them more. Give them food. It pushes you to love your enemies too. Buy Starbucks for someone that you don't like. The Bible says like pouring hot coal in there. So you have that. It's the Spirit that does that. I mean, I've read many stories about missionaries going out there have been killed, but sometimes the husband's been killed and the wife still stays and ministers to those people. I've heard stories about that. The husband's been killed and the wife still went and loved them. And they repented because she showed the love of the Spirit from God. And they were saved because they saw that. My youth pastor showed a lot of love to me when I ran. I was saved because of that. I saw his love. So we need the Spirit of love. It gives you power too. Mario, power. Stronger. Satan is strong, but not stronger than him. But I know he'll fight against me. I need his spirit, his power, to fight the enemy. I can't fight the enemy myself. I need him to fight the enemy. Romans chapter 15, verse 13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy, peace, and believing, so the power of the Holy Spirit may abound you in hope. It's the power of the Holy Spirit that gives you hope, gives you life. It opens your eyes to, it magnifies. When you read, I have read the Bible several times. Sometimes when I go back, oh, more meaning to me. Because he's giving me the power. Depend on him. When I'm here, I depend on the Holy Spirit. I tend to pray, but I think I forgot to pray, but he knows I depend on him. Not just me. I make the PowerPoints and I take his words, I put in them. I do my research and talk with the Spirit. Sometimes he gives me a message that's different where I was supposed to preach. But when I'm here, I use the Spirit. Sometimes he puts into my mind and I preach through him. His power. Chapter 3. I pray that his glorious riches may strengthen you with power through his spirit in a being. So we need his power. Acts chapter 1, verse 8. When you receive power, the Holy Spirit comes upon you. You'll be my witnesses in Jerusalem and all the Judea, Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. You know the story? The people in the upper room, 120 people up there, they pray. Jesus told them, go up there, go and wait for the power. They haven't experienced the power, but they trusted Jesus. And they knew it was important because they saw Jesus full of the power. I want that power. Spoke in tongues, spoke in other languages, people understood their own language. You know how many people were saved in that time? 3,000. Wow, 3,000. He talks more about more people were saved. They received him because they have the power. They use this power. How many of you are comfortable standing up here and talking? I want to do the Bible game. No. Next week I'm saying, Lord, I fill them with the power. So they come up here. Studying. Speaking. Are you brave enough to go out there and preach? The streets, walking. Hey, Jesus loves you. God bless you. You see someone hurting? Sit with them. How can I help you? I pray for you. something simple as giving a church card to someone. Here you go. Hope to see you this Sunday. Hope you're nice to them. When you meet someone who's deaf, and you talk, then when you finish, give them a card. Invite them to church. See as simple as that. It gives you faith. Ignore the pictures. It's the same pictures. It gives you faith. I just realized that. I forgot to put my pictures in. We need faith. It's what Jesus. We believe what Jesus did a long time ago. Faith. Without seeing but believing. It guides us. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 17. That Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith to the end, being rooted and grounded in love. So there's love again. It's Christ. It's the Spirit that guides you to have faith. So what continues keeping your faith in Him. Sometimes the flesh is like, is it real? So it's faith in Christ. But you need the Spirit to guide you. And it's faith that roots you with Him. And it's faith that keeps you in love. Going out there, they have faith. Tithe and offering. Ooh, that's faith, right? God asks us to give. Sure. Thank you. The Spirit gives us faith. Now I give. He'll take care of me. Doesn't matter the amount that I give. He will take care of me. And it's faith. Jude chapter 1, verse 10. For you, dear friends, building yourself in the most holy faith, praying the Holy Spirit. When you depend on the Spirit, when you see the Spirit working, it builds up your faith. God does many miraculous things. He healed people. He cast out demons. Provide for our needs. Let's spend time and I pray in the Spirit, Lord, I have a need. And He provides. The Spirit builds our faith. There's many wonderful things to be successful. You need the passion the Spirit gives you. You need the passion, the motivation. It's the Spirit that motivates you. So now, when we have the Spirit, you receive it and you use it. It's kind of like this. Bugs. You like bugs? Yuck. But when you have the light on outside, you see the bugs. Because they love the light, right? We were in darkness, but we see the Spirit. Light of the world, it attracts bugs. It attracts people. It attracts people. When you have the light, they look up to you like, what do you have? I want that. The Spirit and Jesus Christ in my life. I want that. I want that joy. They can see. They can see the light. Jesus said this. John chapter 8, verse 12. Jesus spoke to people and said, I am the light of the world. Who follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Jesus was full of the Spirit. He had the light. pass down the light as well to us. Jesus said, who walks with me? She said, the Spirit will never walk in darkness. But the key is this, whoever follows me, we can live in the Spirit and follow him. You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Because we have the Spirit in us, with the light of the world is showing. It may seem dark out there, but because of our light, we're fighting against darkness. We're pushing it out. We're keeping the world a better place. And because of us, with the light, remember, the Spirit speaks for you too. Matthew chapter 10, verse 20. For you will not be speaking, but the Spirit of your Father speaks through you. We have the Spirit and love to speak for us. We witness. Sometimes we meet people. We don't know the situation sometimes. But the Spirit will come in and speak the right word. I have seen people that just met this person. They felt the Spirit said, you have this problem. And they just say it like, they're like, how did you know that? The Spirit of God. The light. The Spirit will guide you. We have to use the Spirit to match. So remember, for our ministry to be stronger and better, powerful, we need to use the Spirit. God has a use for each one of us all. But we need the Spirit to be effective in His ministry. If you depend on yourself, you will fail. So I need the Spirit. So you need the Spirit. Take a minute to think. To thank the Spirit. And tell the Spirit to come. I'm going to pray. You pray with me. Father in heaven, Lord, thank you for the Spirit. I ask for your Spirit to fill me and overflow. Continue overflowing. I want to be stronger. I want to minister for you. I know I need your power as a ministry. The Spirit gives us life. Gives us faith. Gives us hope, speaks for us. And I need that Spirit. I ask Holy Spirit to work in me, eliminate what does not belong to you. Clean me, make me stronger. Because I'm going to follow you, so I'll not walk in darkness. I ask you to bless each one of us. Thank you, Jesus, name I pray. Amen. Worship team. Thank you. Bye Club. Say one more thing. You have an opportunity to come up and we'll pray for you. You need to receive the Spirit. Like in the morning, when I'm tired, I receive coffee and drink. It refreshes me. It wakes me up. Sometimes it makes me a little bit hyper. But I'm going to give you the opportunity if you want. We'll pray for you. For the Spirit to grow. So you're welcome to come on up. It could be any other prayers.